Welcome to the course Compiler Design. In this lecture, now we'll discuss about how to solve data flow equations. So in our previous lecture, we discussed about how to set up data flow equations, then various concepts related to data flow equations are discussed. So now using those prerequisite concepts, so after setting up equations of data flow equation for a basic block in the given flow graph. So using one iterative solution of data flow equation. So we can solve the data flow equations here. So here we will use the solution, iterative solution of data flow equations. So we are having one algorithm for this iterative solution. The equations for many data flow problems are similar in form, in that information is being generated and killed. So generated means in the equation GEN, killed is nothing but in the equation kill. However, there are two principal ways in which equations differ in detail. The first one is the equations for reaching definitions are forward equations, in the sense that the outsets are computed in terms of the insets using in value. We shall also see data flow problems that are backward, in that the insets are computed from the outsets. So initially insets are computed from outsets, then outsets are computed from insets, like that. For initial configuration, we'll use this one. The second principle, when there is more than one edge entering a block B, that means incoming edge, predecessor of that block. So when there is more than one edge entering block B, the definitions reaching the beginning of that block are the union. You can take the union of the definitions arriving along each of the edges. We therefore say that union is the confluence operator. In contrast, we shall consider problems like global available expressions, where intersection is the confluence operator, whereas in global case, because an expression is only available at the beginning of a block B, if it is available at the end of every predecessor of that block. So these are the two principles will be considered. If more than one incoming edge, then you can take the union. So whereas globally, if there is more than one edge entering the block B, the definitions reaching the block B or the union, then we therefore union is the confluence operator. So then opposite to that, we shall consider problems like global available expressions, where intersection is the confluence operator, because an expression is only available at the beginning of B, only one expression. If it is available even at the end of every predecessor of that block, at that time you can take intersection. Now let us move to the iterative algorithm for reaching definitions. For each basic block B, we can define out of B, gen of B, kill of B, and in of B. These are all the various terms available in the general data flow equation. By noting that each block B may be viewed as a statement, that is the cascade of one or more assignment statements combining, suppose S1, S2. This is called as cascade of statements. Assuming that gen and kill have been computed for each block, we can create two groups of equations shown below that relate in and out. So we already discussed how to compute gen and kill value in our previous class. So now we need to compute in and out values. Those can be divided into the following two groups. Group one consisting of the formula for in of a basic block B equal to union. Here you can take P. What is P? A predecessor of B. For the block B, all incoming blocks you need to consider in place of P. Then you can take union of all these blocks out value, that is out of P. For example, here P equal to B1 comma B2, let us say. So then in of B equal to, here you can take out of B1 union out of B2. Like that, we will take the union of all predecessors of B. That is group one. First, we need to compute in value. Why? Because in the general equation of data flow equation, the formula is the gen of a block is defined as, So out of a block is defined as in terms of gen of B union, then in of B minus kill of B. So we know how to compute gen and kill that we discussed in the previous class. Now we need to compute in value using this formula. In of B equal to union P, a predecessor of B, out of P. Like that, you can compute for that particular block. Block-wise, you can apply this formula iteratively. That's why this is iterative algorithm, what we are discussing here. Then once you know in of that particular block, you can compute out value. For out value, the formula is gen of B union, in of B minus kill of B. The first group of equations follow from the observations that in of B is the union of the definitions arriving from all predecessors of B. And the second group or special case of the general law, that is out of S equal to gen of S union, in of S minus kill of S, that we claim holds for all statements. Now, if a flow graph has n basic blocks, so n basic blocks, then we get 2n equations from 1 and 2 groups, above, in and out. The 2n equations can be solved by treating them as recurrences for computing in and out sets, just as the data flow equation. So now, in of S1 equal to in of S union out of S1, and out of S equal to gen of S union in of S minus kill of S. Like that, we have to, by using recurrence relation. Now let us see the algorithm, the iterative algorithm to compute in and out. For gen and kill, algorithm is not required. Directly we can compute. Only we need to compute in and out. That is called as reaching definitions of in and out. The algorithm name is called as reaching definitions. What is the input required for this? A flow graph for which kill and gen of that particular basic block have been computed for each block B. We know how to compute kill and gen values. Then output is which consisting of in of that block and out of that block. For each block, we need to compute in and out values. Now let us see the method here. We use an iterative approach, starting with the estimate by assuming in of B as empty for all blocks B, and converging to the desired values of in and out, as we must iterate until the ins and hence the outs converge. We use a Boolean variable change to record one each pass through the blocks whether any in has changed. So when you can stop this algorithm, suppose you can proceed to continue in and out value with different passes. Pass one, initial value. Pass two depends on pass one. Pass three depends on pass two. And so on, pass n depends on pass n minus one. So whenever pass n minus one is same as pass n, then we can stop. Like in our automata theory, we are having one concept, NFA to DFA. So what we have to do, first we'll take initial state. From the initial state with all given input symbols, we can find out the transitions. Whenever a new state occurred, then that new state will be considered as the next state of DFA. Again, for that new state, you can find the transitions on all the given input symbols. Like that, we have to proceed till no new states are repeated. further all are repeated, no new states occurred, then you can stop. Then those are the final states of the DFA. With that, you can construct its automaton and transition diagram. Even our data flow equation also in the similar concept. First initial pass we have to consider, then proceed to pass 2, that depends on pass 1, pass 3, that depends on pass 2, and so on. Suppose if pass 3 values are same as in pass 2, then you can stop. So like that, we have to proceed to solve data flow equations for each and every basic block in the given flow graph. This iterative algorithm, it continues till the last pass values repeated with the previous pass values. Then you can stop like that. Now let us see the algorithm here. So first we have to initialize out on the assumption in of b equal to 5 for all blocks. For all blocks initially we have to assume in of b equal to 5. Then out of b can be obtained from initially by using gen of b values. For each block b, do out of b equal to gen of b. Here what we assume, this is for initial. But next pass we will use the formula, that is out of b equal to gen of b union in of b minus kill of b. Then you can assume change as initially true. That means changes are there. No change means false. Further, same value is repeating means no change. Whenever values are changing means you can assume it as true. While change, then do begin. Then change equal to false. Here no change occurred. Then each block B, do begin. In of B equal to the formula group 1. What we discussed above. Group 1. In of B equal to union P, a predecessor of B, out of P. So all incoming blocks of B named as P, you can take union of out of those values. Then initially old out initial value, you can take it from out of B. Then out of B equal to current next one. Next pass, gen of B union, in of B minus kill of B. If out of B not equal to old out value, then change equal to true. Again change occurred, end. So like that, you can repeat this algorithm iteratively. This very simple algorithm. Okay, now let us demonstrate one example here. The flow graph is shown below. Okay, now let us solve this problem lively. So here again, separately, I will take here. So solving data flow equations, given flow graph, given flow graph as shown below. Parallelly, you also try to solve this problem. So what it contains, in our previous class, whatever the example we have considered, same example is taken here. First, the definitions in block 1, I equal to M minus 1, that is definition 1. Definition 2, J equal to N. Then definition 3, A equal to U1. So this is basic block 1. This is designated as the initial block. Then next block, which contains next definition D4, I equal to I plus 1. Then D5, J equal to J minus 1. This is basic block 2. Now here I am drawing the flow graph, a given example flow graph. So then after B1, B2, you are having a B3 block, which consisting of the definition D6, A equal to U2. So this is B3 block. So then you are having B4 block. The definition is D7, I equal to U3. This is B4 block. Now these are all connected from B2 to B3. So then B2 to B4. Then there are loops. One is from B4 to B2, B2 B4 to B2, we are having one loop. Then B3 to B2 also we are having one loop. B3 to B2. So this is the given flow graph, which illustrates the reaching definitions. In B1, three definitions are there, D1, D2, D3. Then B2, two definitions named with D4, D5. Then B3, only one definition, D6. Then B4, only one definition, D7. So now what you have to do? First, we need to define the initial values in the previous class, what we discussed. Now let us see here. The table we will consider like this. First, block B, then initial. So first we will compute in of B, then out of B. So then we will take pass 1, in of B, then out of B, then pass 2, in of B, then out of B. Like that, we have to continue till a particular pass is same as previous pass values. This is the table you can take. So now here, what are the blocks we are having? B1 to B4. Four blocks are there. Now the blocks B1, B2, B3, B4. These are the blocks you are having. For every block, pass wise, you can compute these in and out values. This is the initial pass. This is the pass 1. For every pass, again, you need to compute in value and out value using the iterative algorithm, whatever the formulas divided into groups. First, before this, what you have to do? You need to find gen and kill values for each and every block. And also here, another important point for the solution, here we will consider bit vector. Here you can see the total definitions D1, D2, and so on, D7, defining only I, J, and A. Here you can see D1 to D7, what are the definitions? IJA combination only. Total, we are having 7 definitions. Then here, what you have to do? We shall represent sets of definitions, that is D1 to D7, by bit vectors 0 and 1's combination. Zeros and 1's combination, where bit I corresponding to the definition DI, where bit I from the left represents definition DI. For example, if you can take a definition for D, means you can take 1. No definition means you can take 0. So now here we will consider a 7-bit vector Since, why? Because we are having 7 definitions. Since initially assume 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Here you can see 7 bits. So everyone corresponding to here D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. So for a particular block, whatever the definitions, suppose 135, only 135 you can make it as 1. All others are 0 initially. Like that we have to consider. Okay, now let us first define the gen values. Gen of B1, whatever the definitions defined in B1, D1, D2, D3. Now you can take D1, D2, D3. Now represent into its bit vector. The bit vector 1 to 7. First 3 you are having definitions. Then remaining 4 are zeros. So this is D1, this is D2, then D3, then remaining D4 to D7. No definitions are there. So this is the bit vector. So in any flow graph, based on the number of definitions, the maximum count of the definition, you can take that size of the bit vector. Then similarly, kill of B1. That means where I, J, A are killed outside of B1. Here you can see in B2, I, J are used, but different definitions. Here I, M minus 1, here I plus 1. Here J, N, here J, J minus 1. So in B2, these are all killed. That means D4, D5. You can write all the differences in the order. Then similarly, check other blocks. In D6 also, A is killed. Here A equal to U1, but here A equal to U2. So D6. Then in B4 also D7, I equal to U3. But here I equal to M minus 1. So these are all killed. Now here you can see 4, 5, 6, 7 are the kill values. Remaining all, you can take 0. 1, 2, 3 are 0. Now 4 is 1, 5 is 1, 6 is 1, 7 is 1. Here, whatever we used. So this is D4, D5, D6, D7. These are all. Similarly, next block B2. So gen of B2 equal to, what are the definitions defined here? D4 and D5. So D4 and D5. It's bit vector 4 and 5, 1, 0, 0, 0, 3, 4. Fourth one is, here you can take, can remove this one. Fourth one is 1. Fifth one is 1. Sixth one again 0. Here we are having D4, D5. This is the bit vector. Similarly, you can find kill of B2. B2 contains I and J, where I and J are defined outside of B1, B2 with different values. Now I in B1, different value. So that is D1, this one. Then J also killed in D2 of B1. Then where I is used in D7 of B4. So only 3 kill values are there. B3 does not contains the definitions of I and J. Now its bit vector is first position 1, second position 1, 30, 40, 50, 60, 71. Here this is D1, second one D2, last one D7. These are all kill of B2. Similarly, for D6, gen of B3. So you are having only one definition, that is D6. Now it's bit vector, only sixth position. 0, 0, 0, 3, 4, 5, 6 is 1, then 7 also 0. This is D6. Now kill of B3. Kill of B3 equal to where A values are killed outside of B3. Here you can see in the first block, A is killed. Why? Because here A equal to U2, but there A equal to U1. So only one block contains killing of A. So that is D3. Here you will get D3. Only third position is 1. 0, 1, 2. Third one is 1. Remaining all 0. That is 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are all kill of B3. Similarly for B4 block, gen of B4 equal to, only one definition is there, D7. That is the last bit is 1, remaining all 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seventh one is 1. That is D7. Now kill of B4. Kill of B4 equal to, so here I is there, where I is killed outside of B4. So I is killed in B1. Why? Because here different definition. Then only one, that is D1. Then in B2 also I is killed, that is D4. So only two places, therefore D1 and D4 are the kill of B4. D1 and D4. Now its bit vector equal to first position 1, second 0, third 0, fourth 1, then fifth 0, sixth 0, seventh 0. So these are all gen and kill values. Why? Because for initial paths, we'll use these values, especially gen values, for computation of in and out. Now coming to our table here. So in this, initially, we already mentioned in the algorithm, the all initial values of all the blocks are pi. So initially this is pi. Pi means no definitions. You can take the bit vector, empty bit vector with zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For all blocks, in of every block initially empty, you can take all are zeros. Now for B2 also, the initial values, only 7 bits you can consider. Now out values, how to calculate initially out of a particular block equal to gen of particular block. Now you can see. So gen values we obtained in the above, in the flow graph, every block we mentioned gen values. So gen of, that is gen of B1. So what is gen of B1 actually? First you can take D1, D2, D3. For understanding purpose, initially 1. Here D1, D2, D3. That means 1, 2, 3 are ones, remaining all zeros. So directly we have taken, here we have written gen of B1 means 111, 4 zeros. So similarly, gen of B2, here you can see 000, 110. Here 000, 111, 1. So for B2, 000, 111, 00. Similarly, for B3, gen of B3. In the above, see what is gen of B3 here? 5 zeros, 1 0. So here, 3, 4, 5 zeros, 1 0. Then for B4, gen of B4. So gen of B4 equal to all zeros, last bit is 1. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2 to 4, 5, 6, last one is 1. So like that, initial out values can be taken from gen values. Now from pass 1 onwards, we need to find out the in and out values. Now how to find, let us see here. Now let us consider pass 1. So for pass 1, what you have to do? First you can take in values for each block B, the formula what we used. Group 1, in of B equal to union P, a predecessor. The predecessor of B, you can take out of P. Here, B equal to, in the above flow graph, the four blocks, B1, B2, B3, B4. So now first we'll consider with B equal to B1 block. For first basic block, let us find in values. Now here you can see, for B1, what are the predecessors? Go back and check the incoming edges, incoming blocks of B1. So for B1, no predecessors, only outgoing is there. So no incoming blocks are there. Then what you have to consider? You can consider again, all are zero only, no definitions. So here, there are no predecessors for the initial node. So in of B1 remains the empty. The empty set represented by all zeros. The 7 bits zeros. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, then 7. So this is in of B1. Now write down here in of B1 in pass 1. So in of B1, this is also empty here. All zeros. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now you need to find out of B1. So for empty set, again, out of B1, you can take from the gen of B1 only. Therefore, as a result, out of B1 remains. Out of B1 remains equal to gen of B1. So now, what is gen of B1 that you can take here? So here, only for block 1 we are taking. This is equal to gen of B1. What is gen of B1 value? Here you can see. Gen of B1 equal to 111 4 zeros. Anyway, here we have used the same. 111 4 zeros. So like that, you can repeat same for B2, B3, B4. So this is for B equal to B1. In and out values are obtained. Now, coming to with B equal to B2 block. Now, what are the predecessors of B2? Go back and check. That is the incoming basic blocks for B2. Now you can see. For B2, B1 is coming. This one incoming. Then from B4 to B2, one loop is there, this one. Then B3 to B2, this loop is there. You can take in of B2 equal to, as per the formula, out of B1 union out of B3 union out of B4. So B1, B3, B4 are the predecessors of B2 block. Now here you can see. With B equal to B2, here B1, B3, and B4 are predecessors of B2. Therefore, the formula in of B2 equal to union here B1, B3, B4. This is P. So out of P. Now this you can expand. Out of V1 union out of V3 union out of B4. You can take the initial values of out values. Why? Because we are at pass 1. So out of B1, so pass 1 depends on initial pass. Pass 2 depends on pass 1. Now we are finding only pass 1 depends on initial. So now here out of B1 means this value. Out of B1, you can take this value. Then out of B3, this value. Out of B4, this value. We can substitute these values here. Why? Because for initial pass. So now here out of B1 equal to 111 40. Union, now this is plus. You can take the Boolean operation plus. Then out of B3 equal to 50. Then 10. Plus out of B4, last bit is 1, remaining all 6 are 0. 4, 5, 6, 1. Now you can, how to add this one? So in switching theory and logic, and or operations, how you are computing for binary values in the similar fashion. You can take like this. First 1, 1, 1. Then 4 zeros. Next value is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, here 1, 0. Then last bit is 1, remaining all zeros. Now you can take the Boolean addition operation. So 0, 0, 1, here you will get 1. 0, 1, 0 plus 1 plus 0, you will get 1. All zeros adding 0, then all zeros 0. 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 0, plus 0, 1. 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1. You will get this. Now this value is 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. This is in of B2 value. 111 00 11. Now you can see that value you can write for B2 block. In of B2 equal to 111, then 0, 0, 1, 1. Similarly, now in value is obtained. Now you can find out value using the formula. Why? Because here this is not empty. So we are having in value. Now for B2 block, now you can calculate out value using the formula. Therefore, for B equal to B2, out of B2, the formula is N of B2 union in of B2 minus fill of B2. Substitute all these values. Now, gen of B2, go back and check from the table. So here, in the previous pass, gen of B2 equal to this one. Then fill values we already obtained in the above. Now here you can see. So gen of B2 equal to 000 11 00. Now union is plus now. Now in of B2, previously we obtained this value. This is nothing but in of B2. So now here 111 00 11 minus kill of B2 in the flow graph beside, we are having kill values. For B2 block, kill of B2 equal to 11 40 1. So kill of B2 equal to 11 40 1. First, what you have to do, the sub-expression subtraction, you can calculate first. So this can be computed. Let us see. First, this one minus this one. We can take 11 00 11, then 1 1 and 2 3 4 1. first minus. So what you will get? 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 0, 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. You will get 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. For this, you have to add this value. Now, let us see here. Then 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. This is plus. Now 0 plus 0, 0. 1 plus 0, 1. 0 plus 1, 1. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. Then 0, 0. Now this is the result. 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Again, this is nothing but, so here D1 is 0, D2 is 0, D3, 1, D4, 1, D5, 1, D6, 1, D7, 0. Wherever ones are there, the definitions are there. So this is out of B2. This value you can substitute here. So here for B2 block, out of B2 equal to 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So like that you have to compute similarly. For one block I will do, remaining you can do. Now for B3, now let us come to B3 block. Now for B equal to B3, first compute in of B3 equal to, so for B3 block, what are the predecessors? Now let us go back and check from the flow graph for B3 block. So B3, we are having only one incoming basic block, that is B2. So in of B3 equal to out of B2. Now you can see this is equal to out of B2. Now, just now here we calculated out of B2 equal to same value you can use here. This is equal to 00, 4 ones, 2 to 4. So 00, 4 ones, 0. This is out of B2 value. Then similarly, you can calculate out of B3 using the same formula. Then out of B3, out of B3 equal to the formula gen of B3 union in of B3 minus kill of B3. We know gen of B3 value from the table. Here you can see. So gen of B3, or you can take from the flow graph itself. For B3 block gen, so 5 zeros, 1 0. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 zeros, 1 0 plus, then in of B3, previously we obtained this value 0 0, 4 1s, 0 minus. Then kill of B3, go back and check from the flow graph. Kill of B3, 0, 0, 1, all zeros. Now this value is 0, 0, 1, then 4 zeros. So now in the similar fashion, first you can find out the subtraction followed by addition. Now here you can see. First, you can compute this one. 0, 0, 4, 1, 0, minus 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. First, subtraction. 0 minus 0, 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 0, 0. So here, 000, 1110, 0. For this, you can add this value. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Now you can add this one, binary addition. 0 0 0 1 1. So 1 1, what you will get here? You will get 1 in case of addition. 1 plus 0 1 1 plus 0 1 0 0 0. Now this value equal to 0 0 0 1 1 0. This is out of B3. Now we can substitute these values here. What we obtained here for B3, so in of B3, what we obtained? 0 0 4 1 0. Then out of B3, what we obtained here? 0 0 0 1 0. Then similarly, now here I'm giving the B4 values directly, so later you can find in the similar fashion. So in of B4, for B4 block, what are the predecessors? Let us see, for B4 incoming blocks only B2. So out of B2, now this will becomes in the table. So out of B2, here same value, this value you can take here 0 0 4 1 0. Then out of B4, you can use the formula gen of B4 union in of B4 minus kill of B4. Here you will get the result as 0 0 1 0 1 1. This you can find. Similarly, you can continue with pass 2. So here I will give pass 2 values. Again, you can repeat pass 2 values depends on pass 1. Suppose you pass 2 values, same values you will get. Then you can stop. Like that, you can apply this iterative algorithm. Here I will give the pass 2 values. Even for in, we don't have any predecessors. We take gen of B1 only. So what you will get? All zeros. Then out of B1, what you will get? Here I am writing the answer. So 1 1 4 0s. You can test it after finding. Then for B2 block, in values, all are 1s. 2 5 6 7. Then out values, 0 0 4 1 0. Then for B3 block, in values, 0 0 4 1 0. Then out values, here I will write 0 0 0 1 0. Then for B4 block, in values, 0 0 4 1 0. Then the out values, 0 0 1 0 1 1. So now you can compare. For example, here, what are the pass 1 out values? 0 0 1 4 0s. Here also 0 0 1 4 0s. Now here B2, here you can see 0 0 4 1 0. Here also same value you are getting. Now here pass 2 out values, 3 0s 0 1 0. 3 0s 0 1 0. Let us see. Here also 0 0 1 0 0 1. 0 0 1 0 0 1. We are getting same out values. So only here we need to check our main target is out value. Pass 2 out values same as pass 1 out values. Then directly here we can't stop here. You can find pass 3 also. But because if pass 3 also repeat the same, then you can stop here. So now, similarly, pass 2 based on pass 1. Then pass 3 based on pass 2. If, suppose, you can find till pass 3. Pass 3 is same as pass 2, then stop. So this is the iterative solution of data flow equations. So we can continue till pass 3. If pass 3 values are same as pass 2 values, then you can stop here. Okay, now that's all about solving data flow equations.